Basically, with Campus Connect, you have the teacher component of it and the student module as well.
Right.
There are two types of user groups in Campus Connect. One is the teachers and the students. As a teacher, you have several administrative privileges, which allows you to edit group announcements and also to create individual user accounts for students. So let me just run you through the main page here. So what we have here is the main interface, which, as you can see, our content is derived from BBC Motion Gallery. We have lots of videos under each subject category, which is located in the tabs here. Over 100 videos per subject. Our content is still under development at the moment, so it's kind of like in beta, but then we'll be adding more videos and more subjects in the coming months. So for example, let me just demonstrate to you what I mean by an interactive video. For the science tab, if you click on this, for example, suppose you're a teacher and you're looking for video resources to aid your lesson plan. So you might go to YouTube or you might go on the internet, but here we have a ready-made product that is customized and adaptable to the school syllabus and curriculum that your school is aligned with, basically. So if I play the video, for example, a hotspot would appear here, which is a marker that's embedded within the video that gives you all the relevant information you need in particular in relation to a subject matter. So for example, the video is on acids and alkalis, and this drop-down menu of information gives you specific information about alkalis. And if you let it play on a bit longer, there will be a quiz option that pops up here. They'll test your knowledge of the subject matter as a student. So it's correct here. And if you don't want to continue watching the video, you can skip straight to the hotspots just by clicking on the round dots here. They'll give you all the information you need about a particular subject that will aid you in the preparation for your exam, so like GCSEs and A-levels, that sort of thing.
Okay.
And you have relevant activities, notes, and discussion questions that are attached to each video. So basically,
Is that with all the content, or is that something the BBC has supplied on this occasion?
The BBC does not supply this. They only supply the video content. And what we do is we customize the videos and we add these hotspots and we add all these educational elements to it that make it much more focused for students. Because if you have just videos that you search on YouTube or videos that are provided, students do not have any direction and they don't know how to systematically learn from it. But here we provide guidance through these hotspots. So it makes it much more interactive and much more guided, the process.
Right, okay.
And you have Web 2.0 functions here which allow you to like and rate the video. And you can also blog the video. And you can also zoom in and out of the video, focus on text.
Right.
Depends on what your preferences are, but it's very interactive. And you can add videos here. So this brings us to VChannel, which is essentially allows students and teachers to have their own video channels, drawing from resources from VResources and all the videos we have in our library, and also their own video clips as well. And what it does is it essentially remember YouTube has their own YouTube channel, right?
Right.
And here we have our own channel for teachers, except it's in a much more educational context. So for example, if you're a teacher and you want to create a channel on chemistry, so let's say this channel is on chemistry, and I provide all the videos here, I upload all the videos here that are related to chemistry, such as acids and alkalis, maybe industrial fractional distillation, like alkenes and alkanes, I can put all the videos in there, and students will be invited to provide feedback, comments, they can like the video, they can ask questions, and then the student and the teacher, as the administrator, will provide answers to them. So you can see here, there's a forum here, function here, that allows students and teachers to exchange ideas and opinions in relation to a particular video.
Right.
So these videos are not just one way, and they're not one-dimensional, they're very multi-dimensional, because everyone will be invited to provide feedback and comments, and then basically it will make the learning process much more collaborative. And it will be very rewarding in that aspect. And
could you explain something you said earlier, the number of devices you can send it to? So you can send it to a tablet and you can send it to television.
Yes.
Also.
Televisions, tablets, mobile devices, your iPhone, your iPad, also through your PC as well. You can view it from just about any medium or platform.
Okay.
Yeah.